Welcome to a second example of exponential regression. The goals of the video are to perform exponential regression on a TI84 graphing calculator, determine how well the regression model fits the data, and then make predictions using the regression equation. Let's start with a quick review of the exponential function. F of x equals a times b to the power of x is an exponential function. If the function increases from left to right, as we see here, we have exponential growth. And if the function is decreasing from left to right, or going downhill from left to right, we have exponential decay. So if our scatter plot behaves in this way, we can use exponential regression to make a prediction equation. Let's go and take a look at our second example. Here we have some data about how fast people are becoming infected by the bird flu over a period of 6 days. Let's go ahead and create a scatter plot on the graphing calculator and see if an exponential function is appropriate to model this data. So the first thing we're going to do is enter the data into the graphing calculator. So we're going to press STAT and then ENTER. And the first thing we need to do is clear out the old data. So we'll go to the top of the column, press CLEAR, and then ENTER. And it will clear the entire column at one time. CLEAR, ENTER. And now we'll enter the new data. L1 will be the first column, L2 will be the second column. And before we graph the scatter plot, we have to set up our window to make sure these data values will show on the screen. So now we'll press the window key, and notice that the x values go from 0 to 6. So I'm going to have the x-axis go from negative 1 to 7. Scale it by 1s. Then the y values go from 1 to 453. So I'm going to scale the y-axis from negative 50 to 500. And I'll scale it by 50s. Now to turn the scatter plot on, there's a couple ways of doing it. The quickest, easiest way, if the data values are in L1 and L2, would be to press the y equals sign, clear out any old equations we have in here, and notice plot 1 is already highlighted. That means the scatter plot is already turned on. If it wasn't, we can just push the up arrow and then press enter to turn it on. The other way is to press second y equals. Notice how plot 1 is turned on here, but if it wasn't, we could press enter, highlight on, and then press enter. This is the scatter plot option. Notice that L1 and L2 are the defaults for x and y, and it's going to plot little squares for the scatter plot. Let's go ahead and press graph. Here's the data. It does look like it's exponential growth. Of course, we could also try quadratic regression to see if that's a better fit. But for this video, we're looking at the exponential function. If we press the trace key, it'll show the coordinates of each point so we can make sure that we entered the data in correctly. And everything looks good. Now before we perform the regression, we want to make sure the calculator gives us R squared, or the coefficient of determination. So we need to make sure the diagnostic tool is turned on. If we press second, 0 brings up the catalog, and now we'll scroll down to D and look for diagnostic on. Here it is, so we'll press enter and then enter one more time. Now let's perform exponential regression. Press STAT, right arrow once, and then look for exponential regression. I believe it's option 0. There it is, we're going to press enter. Now before we press enter, we're going to select y1, and that way the regression equation will be stored directly into y1, so we don't have to enter it by hand. So we're going to press vars, right arrow once, enter, enter. And now we'll press enter one more time. It'll give us the regression equation, our diagnostic information, and the equation is also stored in y1. Notice that r squared is approximately 0.91, which tells us that approximately 91% of the variability in the data can be explained by this model. If we press graph, we have a nice visual of the scatter plot and the regression equation plotted on the same coordinate plane. Notice how the function goes up very quickly and the data may not, so this tells us that making predictions past 6 weeks, this equation may not be the best choice for our model, but from the days from 0 to 6, it does look pretty good. Let's go ahead and write the equation of this model down and then try to answer some questions based upon this model. And we'll go ahead and round to 3 decimal places. One thing I want to point out right away is notice that when x is equal to 0, 2.655 to the 0 would be equal to 1. And so according to our model, the initial amount or number of people infected is approximately 2.4. But according to the actual data, when x is 0, there's only 1 person affected. So right away, we do have a margin of error, but that's usually the case for any model. First question is, if the spread is not contained, how many people would be infected after 14 days? So they're asking us, when x is equal to 14, what would the y value be? Let's go and answer this using the graphing calculator. Let's press second window. Notice our table will start at 0, increase by 1s, and everything else is on automatic. So if we press second graph, we can just scroll down to x equals 14, and it will tell us the corresponding y value. This indicates it would be approximately 2.18 times 10 to the power of 6. Another way to answer this question, so that we can see more digits of this value, would be to go back to the home screen, second mode, press vars, right arrow once, enter, enter, and we'll determine what y1 of 14 would be. So we'll just put 14 in parentheses, just like function notation. It'll give us the value showing more digits. So it's going to be approximately 2,178,722 people. So this is the power of exponential growth, and one of the reasons why it's important to contain new infections of new diseases. However, if we go back to our graph for a minute, notice how our function is increasing rather rapidly, even though the data doesn't seem to be increasing quite as fast. So this may not be the best estimate, but it is our estimate based upon the model. Number 2 asks, what is the doubling time? Again, let's go ahead and go back to the graphing calculator. Remember, we said that when x is equal to 0, the initial value according to the model was approximately 2.388. Let's just call it 2.4. So the doubling time would be how long it would take for approximately 4.8 people to be infected, doubling the initial amount. So what we can do is go to y equals, go down to y2, enter in the doubling amount, or approximately 4.8, and see when these two functions intersect. However, to do that, we're probably going to have to adjust the window, because 4.8 may not show up if we have a maximum y value of 500. So let's go ahead and change the y-axis from negative 1 to 8, and then press graph. So there's our exponential function, there's our horizontal line, and the x value of this point of intersection would represent the doubling time. So let's go ahead and press second, trace, option 5, enter, enter, and then when it says guess, let's go ahead and move the cursor closer to that point of intersection. And enter one more time. So it looks like the doubling time is approximately 0.71 days. Now I realize we could have used a formula to determine the doubling time, but it's also nice to be able to utilize technology to answer this type of question because we could see it visually. Number 3, when will the number of infected people reach 100,000? So this question is asking, when y is equal to 100,000, what would the x value be? Let's go back to the calculator. Let's go to our table. Notice that y is equal to 100,000 somewhere between x equals 10 and x equals 11. So let's go ahead and adjust the window so that we can see this point of intersection. So the x max will have to be at least 11, and the y max will have to be at least 100,000. So we'll press window, let's change the y max to 12, let's change the y minimum to negative 500, and the y maximum to, let's say, 110,000. Now let's press y equals, and then we'll enter in 100,000 in y2. Let's go ahead and press graph and see if the point of intersection shows on the screen. There's our model, and there's the line y equals 100,000. So the x value of this point of intersection will tell us when will 100,000 people be infected according to the model. So we'll press second, trace for the calculation menu, option 5, enter, enter, And then before we press enter on guess, we'll move the cursor closer to that point of intersection. Press enter one more time. So it's going to occur at approximately 10.86 days, again, according to the model. You can see why a model for the spread of a new disease would be very important, because it gives some very valuable information for public health. The last question, do you believe this is a good model for this situation? Why or why not? Well, we said earlier that R squared is approximately 0.91, so approximately 91% of the variability of the data could be explained using this model. However, we only had data for the first 6 days, so making a prediction of, let's say, at 14 days is way outside the given data, and therefore there's probably going to be the possibility of a larger margin of error. So I'll go ahead and leave this for you to think about. Hope you found this helpful, and thank you for watching.